Welcome to Gospel Review Podcast.
Been there since the early days of Christianity. MTS Tayab reports on the material and the amazing story it tells.
Good morning. Well, when the Dead Sea Scrolls were first found over 70 years ago, it was widely considered to be one of the most important archaeological discoveries of the 20th century. The biblical text, nearly 2,000 years old, gave us a rare insight into the history of Judaism, early Christianity, and humankind, with these new findings shining an even brighter light onto our past. It's called the Cave of Horror. And it's easy to see why, given the only way for archaeologists to access it is by rappelling down the side of a sheer cliff. Although the history of the...
Up down or below my bully boys blow. There once was a ship that put to sea. The name of the ship was a Bully of Tea. The winds blew up her bowed up down or below.
Kumo Prime Time loses viewers as Cuomo is banned from covering Brother. Viewers have turned away from CNN's Cuomo Prime Time since namesake host Chris Cuomo's Big Brother, New York Gov. Andrew Cuomo, D., went from a darling of the liberal media to a scandal-plagued politician facing calls to resign. Cuomo Prime Time averaged 2.2 million viewers from March 20 to June 24, 2020, when the now embattled governor regularly appeared on his Kid Brother's program, often for lighthearted interviews.
For some, simply getting to a vaccination site is next to impossible, either because of distance or disability. So an innovative program in Maryland is taking COVID vaccines on the road, getting doses to those in need. ABC's Terry Moran has the story.
Long lines, even longer waits for a COVID vaccine that could mean the difference between life and death. But for Barbara Feldman, a mother of three who lives in rural Carroll County, Maryland, waiting in line for a vaccine isn't an option.
Most families that have typical children, they're going to go back to a normal, and we're not. Our life has been upside down for 21 years.
Her two sons, 19-year-old Andrew and 20-year-old Jack, both have rare genetic disorders that also make them vulnerable to lung and respiratory issues. And because of their developmental disabilities, they don't understand the importance of masks in public places.
Because they're vulnerable, they would be very much at risk if they got COVID.
Exactly. That and Jack will not wear a mask, so of course I'm going to protect him. And if he won't wear a mask, I'm not going to put him in a situation where it's just not worth it.
So for them, a mobile vaccine unit that comes to their home is literally a lifeline.
It was finally a nurse from the health department that was just doing one of her quality checkups with us that asked if we would want them to come to the house. And I was like, absolutely, we would love for them to come to the house.
And today, their prayers answered.
Perhaps certain events in history are better left untold.